Hello friends, welcome to anujindal.in. So in this video I am going to discuss with you some important numerical questions from the topic of partnership. Okay, so you know that in SEBI grade examination paper 2 there are 6 subjects and one of those subjects is commerce and accountancy. So some numerical questions can be expected in the examination. So let us discuss some questions from the topic of partnership. So let us read the question. A, B, C are equal partners. Equal partners means they have equal share in the profit and losses. D is admitted to the firm for 1/4 share. Okay. A new partner is being admitted for 1/4 share. D brings rupees 20,000 capital and rupees 5,000 for goodwill. You have to calculate the value of the goodwill for the firm. This is a very simple and straightforward question. So he has brought 5,000 rupees for goodwill. Okay. And what is the share of D? The share of D is 1/4. So what will be the total goodwill? It will be the reciprocal of 1/4, which is 4/1. Okay. So the total goodwill of the firm, it will be rupees 20,000. This was a very simple question. I hope you guys will not have any problem in this question. So the correct answer is option C, rupees 20,000. Now moving on to the next question. Question 2, it says the profit of last 3 years are 43,000, 38,000 and 45,000. Find out the value of the goodwill if it is valued at 2 years purchase of average profit. So there are different methods of calculating goodwill. Okay. So as per this method, what you have to do, first of all, you have to calculate the average profit. So you are given 3 years profit. So the average of those 3 years. So 43,000 plus 38,000 plus 45,000 divided by 3. Okay. So if you add it up, it will come out to be 43 plus 45, 88,000 plus 26, 1,26,000. Divided by 3. So this will come out to be 42,000. So 42,000 is the average profit. Now how will we calculate the goodwill? So goodwill is equal to average profit multiplied by 2 years purchase, which means you have to multiply it by 2. Okay. So it will be 42,000 into 2, 84,000. So the goodwill is rupees 84,000, option B. I hope this is clear. Now moving to the next question. Question 3. Goodwill of a firm is to be valued at 3 years purchase of 4 years average profit. The profits earned by the firm in the previous 4 years are given to you as 15,000, 11,000, 18,000 and 16,000. You have to calculate the goodwill. So again the same method as was in the previous question. So first of all you have to calculate the average profit. So average profit will be 15,000 plus 11,000. So K means 1,000. Okay. 18,000 plus 16,000 divided by 4. So 15 plus 11, 26, 26 plus 18, 44, 44 plus 16 is equal to 60. So 60,000 divide by 4. So average profit comes out to be rupees 15,000. And what is the goodwill? So for the purpose of goodwill, you have to multiply the average profit by the numbers of year purchase. So the number of years purchase is 3 years purchase. Okay. So for 15 into 3 is equal to 45,000. So rupees 45,000 is the amount of goodwill, option B. Okay. So this is the simple method. Now next move to the next method, to the calculation of goodwill. So this is the super profit method. Okay. So if capital employed by a partnership firm is 1 lakh. Okay. So the capital employed or the investment in the partnership firm is rupees 1 lakh and the average profit is 20,000. Normal rate of return is given as 15%. So capital employed is given as rupees 1 lakh. Average profit is given to you as 20,000. Okay. And rate of return, ROR, is given as 15%. So you have to calculate the goodwill based on 1 year purchase of super profit. Now what is super profit? You have to understand. So super profit is equal to योर एवरेज प्रॉफिट और योर एक्चुअल प्रॉफिट, ओके, माइनस नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला टू कैलकुलेट सुपर प्रॉफिट. नाउ व्हाट इज नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट? सो नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग द कैपिटल एम्प्लॉयड विद द नॉर्मल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न, विच इन दिस केस इज 15%. सो नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट कम्स आउट टू बी ₹15,000. ओके, सो सुपर प्रॉफिट विल बी एवरेज प्रॉफिट विच इज 20,000 माइनस नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट विच इज 15,000. सो सुपर प्रॉफिट कम्स आउट टू बी ₹5,000. आई होप अप टिल हेयर एवरीथिंग इज क्लियर. सो वी हैव गॉट सुपर प्रॉफिट एज ₹5,000. नाउ व्हाट विल बी द गुडविल? गुडविल विल बी सिंपली द सुपर प्रॉफिट विच इज 5,000 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द नंबर ऑफ ईयर परचेज. सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन इट इज गिवन 1 year परचेज, सो वी विल मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 1. सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज ₹5,000, ऑप्शन बी. ओके, आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. टू मेक इट मोर क्लियर, लेट अस डिस्कस वन मोर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस मेथड ओनली, सुपर प्रॉफिट मेथड ओनली. सो राहुल एंड अविनाश हैड अ फर्म इन विच दे हैड इन्वेस्टेड ₹50,000. ओके, सो कैपिटल इंप्लॉयड इन दिस केस इज 50,000. ऑन एन एवरेज द प्रॉफिट्स वर 16,000. सो एवरेज प्रॉफिट इज गिवन टू यू एज 16,000. नॉर्मल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न इज गिवन एज 15%. सो ROR इज गिवन एज 15%. सो गुडविल इज टू बी वैल्यूड एट 4 years परचेज ऑफ प्रॉफिट इन एक्सेस ऑफ 15% ऑन द मनी इन्वेस्टेड. ओके, सो इट इज 4 years परचेज. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट. सो एज आई टोल्ड यू इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन, नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग द कैपिटल इंप्लॉयड विद द रेट ऑफ रिटर्न. ओके, सो 50,000 इंटू 15%, दिस विल कम आउट टू बी 7,500. ओके, सो वॉट विल बी द सुपर प्रॉफिट? सुपर प्रॉफिट विल बी एवरेज प्रॉफिट विच इज 16,000 माइनस नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट विच इज 7,500. ओके, इट कम्स आउट टू बी 8,500. दिस इज सुपर प्रॉफिट. नाउ वॉट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ गुडविल? सो गुडविल विल बी सुपर प्रॉफिट विच इज 8,500 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 4 years परचेज. सो मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 4, सो दिस कम्स आउट टू बी 34,000. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ गुडविल कम्स आउट टू बी ₹34,000, ऑप्शन बी. आई होप नाउ दिस मेथड इज वेरी वेरी क्लियर. नाउ वी कैन मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सो दिस इज अगेन अ न्यू मेथड. सो अ फर्म अर्न्स 3 lakh एज प्रॉफिट. ओके, सो द प्रॉफिट इज गिवन टू यू एज 3 lakhs. ओके, नॉर्मल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न ROR इज गिवन टू यू एज 12%. ओके, देन एसेट्स ऑफ द फर्म आर 36 lakh एक्सक्लूडिंग गुडविल एंड लाइबिलिटीज आर 12 lakh. सो वॉट विल बी द नेट एसेट्स? द नेट एसेट्स विल बी 36 lakh माइनस 12 lakh. दिस कम्स आउट टू बी 24 lakh. दिस इज द नेट एसेट्स ऑफ द कंपनी. ओके, सो इफ यू लुक एट द नेम ऑफ द मेथड ऑल्सो, कैपिटलाइजेशन ऑफ एवरेज प्रॉफिट, इट मीन्स यू हैव टू कैपिटलाइज द प्रॉफिट. सो हाउ विल यू कैपिटलाइज? सो यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई द प्रॉफिट, द एवरेज प्रॉफिट, बाय द इनवर्स ऑफ द रेट ऑफ रिटर्न. ओके, सो इफ यू विल सॉल्व दिस, दिस विल कम आउट टू बी ₹25 lakhs. दिस विल कम आउट टू बी ₹25 lakh. तो दिस इज द कैपिटलाइज्ड वैल्यू ऑफ द फर्म. सो द कैपिटलाइज्ड वैल्यू ऑफ द फर्म कम्स आउट टू बी ₹25 lakhs, वेयर एज द वैल्यू ऑफ द एसेट इट वॉज 24 lakhs नेट एसेट्स. सो नेट एसेट्स आर 24 lakhs एंड कैपिटलाइज्ड वैल्यू इज 25 lakhs. सो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू इज द गुडविल. सिंस कैपिटलाइज्ड वैल्यू इज मोर देन द नेट एसेट्स, there is a goodwill of ₹1 lakh. There is a goodwill of ₹1 lakh. So the correct answer for this question is option A, ₹1 lakh. I hope this is very, very clear to you. This is called capitalization of average profit method. Okay. Now moving on to the next question. So this is the 7th question now. Ram and Shyam are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. So profit sharing ratio is given as 3:2. Having the capital of 1,80,000 and 1,50,000 respectively, they are entitled to 10% per annum interest on capital before distributing the profits. Okay. So before distributing the profits, the partnership firm has to pay the partners interest on capital. Okay, then it is given that during the year the firm earned 7,800 after allowing interest on capital. This is very, very important. So this amount of 7,800, it has been arrived after deducting the interest on capital. Okay, so you have to calculate that how much profit will be apportioned among Ram and Shyam. So in this question, this 7,800 profit is after allowing the interest on capital. So you need not deduct anything from it. If it was before allowing interest, then we would have deducted the interest on capital, and after that we would have divided the profit among Ram and Shyam. But in this case, this profit is after deducting the capital, after deducting the interest on capital. So we can simply divide this amount between Ram and Shyam in the profit sharing ratio. So Ram will get 3 by 5 of 7,800. This will come out to be 4,680, and Shyam will get 2 by 5 of 7,800. This will come out to be 3,120. Okay. So I hope this is very, very clear to you. So the correct answer is option A, rupees 4,680 and rupees 3,120. Now let us move to the next question. Amit and Bharat are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted Chetan as a new partner for 3/10 share, which he acquired 2/10 from Amit and 1/10 from Bharat. Calculate the new profit sharing ratio of Amit, Bharat and Chetan. Okay. So you have two partners, Amit and Bharat. They are sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. Now they have admitted a new partner, Chetan, for 3/10 share. And it is given that 2/10 he has taken from Amit and 1/10 he has taken from Bharat. Now you have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio of A, B and C. So the new profit sharing ratio of C, we know it is 3/10. So we have to calculate for A and B. So for A, the new profit share, the new share of A will be 3/5, which is the old share minus the sacrificing fraction. So they have sacrificed 2/10. So 3/5 minus 2/10, this comes out to be 4/10. And if I talk about Bharat, he was having old share of 2/5 and he has given 1/10 share. So 2/5 minus 1/10, this comes out to be 3/10. So the shares of A, B and C, it is 4/10, 3/10 and 3/10. Okay. So the ratio comes out to be 4:3:3. I hope this is very, very clear to you. So the correct answer is option C, 4:3:3. Now moving to the next question. Again, a question of new profit sharing ratio. So A and B are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 4:3. So A and B, they are sharing profits in the ratio of 4:3. They agreed to admit C in the firm for 1/6 share. So they are admitting a new partner for 1/6 share. Okay. The new profit sharing of A, B and C. You have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. Now in the previous question, you were given that how much A is giving up and how much B is giving up. But in this question, you are not given. So in that case, you have to divide this 1/6 in their profit sharing ratio, which means the new share of A, it will be 4/7, which is the old share, minus 4/7 into 1/6. Okay. So this will come out to be 4/7 minus 4/42. So if you take the LCM, it will come out to be 20/42. And similarly for B, it will be 3/7 minus 3/7 into 1/6. So if you will solve it, it will come out to be 3/7 minus 3/42. Okay. Again, if we take the LCM, it will come out to be 18 minus 3/42, which is 15/42. So the new share of A comes out to be 20/42. And the new share of B comes out to be 15/42. And what is the new share of C? It is 1 by 6, which is equal to 7 by 42. So what is the shares of these three? So the share of A is 20 by 42. The share of B is 15 by 42. And the share of C is 7 by 42. So the ratio comes out to be 20 is to 15 is to 7. So the correct answer is option C. Okay, I hope this is very, very clear to you. Now let us move to the last question for the day. So in this question, we have to calculate the sacrificing ratio. So A and B are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 5 is to 3. On admission of C, new profit sharing ratio between A, B and C is 7 is to 5 is to 4. You have to calculate the sacrificing ratio. So this is not a very different question. So basically you are given the old profit sharing ratio and you are given the new profit sharing ratio. So basically you have to calculate the sacrificing ratio. So the old ratio is given to you as 5 is to 3. Okay. And the new ratio between the three partners, it is given to you as 7 is to 5 is to 4. Now how to calculate the sacrificing ratio? It is basically the old ratio minus the new ratio. Okay. So if I calculate the sacrificing ratio of A, it will be the old ratio, which is 5 by 8, minus the new ratio, which is 7 by 16. So if you take the LCM, it will come out to be 10 minus 7, which is 3 by 16. And if I calculate the sacrificing ratio for B, it will be old ratio, which is 3 by 8, minus the new ratio, which is 5 by 16. So if you take the LCM again, it will come out to be 6 minus 5, which is 1 by 16. So sacrificing ratio is always for the old partners, because the new partner does not have a share in the old profit. Okay, the new partner only has a share in the new profits. So sacrificing ratio is only calculated for the old partners. Okay, so the sacrificing ratio now comes out to be 3 by 16 for A and 1 by 16 for B. So the ratio is 3 is to 1. Ratio is 3 is to 1 between A and B. The correct answer is option E, 3 is to 1. I hope this is very, very clear. So friends, I have tried to cover different questions from the topic of partnership, which can be asked in the examination. So questions can be asked from the topic of goodwill, from the topic of profit sharing ratio, from the profit of sacrificing ratio. Okay. And there are some other topics like current account, capital account. So I hope friends, you must have liked this video. So if you have liked this video, do subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon. And moreover, if you have any query or doubt, you can ask in the comment section below. So all the very best. Have a nice day.